editing an AI draft into a high-quality client deliverable. Hello, professional family. Hey, artists, making that living online. We're making art in wherever our communities happen to be. Hey, y'all, I'm Caroline Cole. This is the business of storytelling. And today we're talking about AI. It's a hot topic. It's everywhere, y'all. There's no way to escape it. The writing world is on fire. Academia is scrambling. English teachers are crying over their coffee. It's a mess. Or is it? Because for those of us in content writing, AI can actually be a helpful assistant. So there's no reason that we can't work with the tools being developed instead of shying away from them or denying that they exist. And to that end, I have found a way that works for several clients already, and I often use these steps when editing an AI draft into a high-quality, actually good client deliverable. So a lot of us are looking for ways to outsource what we call the shitty first draft, and there's no reason why AI can't do some of the dirty work for us here. Because let's face it, AI content writing tools are becoming increasingly popular as they help businesses to generate large quantities of content quickly and easily. But it's important to note that also on the other side of that, AI-generated content, we know, is not always the highest quality. All that said, here are a few ways that I have figured out with some of my clients that we can edit an AI draft, save some time with the rough draft, but still create a quality client deliverable. One, check for factual accuracy. AI content writing tools sometimes generate inaccurate or misleading information, so don't just take it on face value. You gotta carefully fact check AI generated stuff to ensure that what it says is accurate and up to date. Then you wanna improve the readability and flow of the content. AI generated content can sometimes be difficult to read and confusing to understand. You wanna make sure you're editing AI drafts to improve readability and flow. So you're gonna look for grammatical errors, correct spelling mistakes, which are rare but do happen, break up long paragraphs into shorter ones, and you want to make sure that the content is on brand and consistent with the other things that you're creating for a client. It might not be consistent with brand voice and style if you're just throwing stuff into AI, so you want to make sure and edit those drafts to ensure that your content is on brand, consistent, speaking to the right audience, and that it mixes well with all your other marketing materials. And of course, you want to add your own insights and expertise, because AI content writing tools can generate general purpose content, but they cannot provide the same level of expertise and insight as a human writer. So you want to make sure and make those original connections yourself, make it more valuable and informative for your readers. So here's a little rundown before we part. First, read the AI draft carefully to get a general understanding of the content. After you understand what's in your rough draft, fact check all that information in the AI draft. They are not known for being consistent with this. Then you want to edit the AI draft to improve flow and readability and ensure that the AI draft is on brand and consistent with anything else that you've created for the client so that it's the same brand voice. And then, of course, you want to add your own insights and expertise. After you have created all of that unique stuff, you want to proofread the AI draft carefully to make sure that you're not missing any errors or omissions. And by taking all those little steps, you can make sure that you're both saving time and keeping the quality high. A couple more things to keep in mind just before I let you go. Tools like Bard, ChatGPT, Grammarly even, you want to be aware of the limitations of those writing tools. They can generate good content, but they're just not perfect, and they probably never will be. So keeping us as writers aware of their limitations so that we can use them effectively, but edit output accordingly. It's a great place to generate ideas and inspiration, but it's not gonna replace human writers. They're just a place to replace some of the dirty work that we can skip. They're not gonna replace us altogether. Once you've edited an AI draft, it's sometimes nice to have another pair of human eyes on it too, to get helpful feedback. So make sure you're working as you're adopting this new kind of stuff into your writing routines. Make sure you're talking to clients and managers and getting feedback to make sure that you're using these in a way that's gonna work for not only you and your business, but your clients as well. So using these things, we can find a way to use AI responsibly and creatively so that it can save us time, but not replace what is really important about the human part of this, which is the creative thinking and problem solving. AI are really helpful assistants, but you are still the boss of your writing company and your writing work. You're responsible for the quality of every word that's delivered. So keep that in mind. Even when you're starting to use AI assistants, you're still responsible for their output. Thanks for coming this week, y'all. I'm Caroline Cole. This is the Business of Storytelling. I send emails once a week. We've still got a freebie for some voiceover artists. If you're into voice acting, that's another one of my niches. You can head over to carolinecolestories.com/freebies to get a free download for your voiceover business. Make sure you guys are following along. I love connecting with you on Instagram and TikTok at Caroline Cole Stories. Subscribe, comment, don't be a lurker, don't be a stranger, comment below. And I'll see you guys in a couple weeks. Bye.